Take a look at this. Water, water, and more water. What you're seeing here is the damage from it. It's closing classrooms at UNM, locking down the library, doing tens of thousands of dollars in damage. Now the cleanup is on just days before classes are set to start at New Mexico's biggest university. The man in charge of it is here to talk about that. President and Dr. Bob Frank. Good morning, Dr. Frank. It's good to see you.
It's great to see you.
How is the cleanup going at UNM? You guys got slammed with the flooding last Friday.
Right, we sure did. 50 buildings were damaged, and it was two buildings got significant damage. So we got 2 inches of rain in 2 hours, and it was a real mess, as you can see in the video there. We are deep into fixing it. We'll be ready for classes on the first day, but two buildings, Hodgen Hall and Centennial, took a real hit.
All right, and those are two of the oldest buildings on campus, Hodgen being the oldest one, the first one there. Any idea that you are this susceptible to this kind of flooding? I know we don't get that kind of rain that often.
Yeah, of course, it's the amount of rain and the intensity of the rain in that quick time. Centennial is a building that always gets hit hard. Hodgen, we were really surprised by the damage we took there. But we're working hard to fix it and clean it up. We'll be ready for students on the first day.
Okay, I know Centennial, too. There are some unique historic documents that got some water damage. You actually froze those, sent them off to a company, I think, in Florida. Does it look like they'll be able to salvage any of that?
Yeah, they're assessing what they can do to reclaim those documents. We've had good experience in the past. Unfortunately, this is a flood zone area where those books are maintained. So this happened once before, but we're optimistic we can fix that.
And what do y'all do to make sure this doesn't happen again?
Well, we're working to make that area more floodproof, but when you get this kind of torrential rains that quickly, it's a real issue for us.
Okay, something else we've seen in the headlines this summer, starting in 2016, New Mexico State is gonna increase its minimum GPA for students going in to 2.75. That's from a 2.5 GPA. Ultimately, that's gonna be up to the Board of Trustees. Has UNM talked about this, and is it something you would support?
Well, UNM is looking at it. We were looking at it before New Mexico State made their decision. We're going a little slower, a little more carefully. The real issue right now is the game's changed at universities, of course, because students take on debt. And if a student comes to the university and they're not prepared to succeed, they leave and they have this debt. And the day they leave, the debt's called. So we need to make sure that students come really well prepared. Single best predictor of success at college is your high school GPA. So that GPA tells us a lot. So what we're doing is we're working with our regents and we're talking to all the critical stakeholders and saying, we're thinking about raising our GPA higher, but at the same time, we recognize that some kids might have a lower GPA for a very good reason. They might have had a parent die, they may have been working 5 jobs, and so we're trying to figure out how do we have a holistic review. So we're working with all these groups to make it very thoughtful. I think we will be raising our GPA, but as we do that, we're trying to make sure we do it and have a very fair review process. So as we do this process, I think sometime in the near future, we will be doing it, and we're talking to the regents and all these critical groups.
Does it sound like there would be maybe some exceptions involved?
There'll be a lot of what we call them backdoor for holistic reviews. So if you don't meet the criteria, you go into the review process, and then you would come into UNM. At times, we have a lot of resources that can help you. So you wouldn't come in the fall, you would come in the spring or the summer, where all of our advisors and our study groups could work with you, and there's more resources available for you. So that's how it would
work. Along those same lines, I know in the past couple of years you started a program for incoming freshmen to help get them up to par in English and math. Right. Is that helping them kind of succeed in college?
We're having great results with those two programs. They have really made a difference. We're following those students. Those students are doing very, very well at the university, and that's why we know these programs will make a difference. So we know we can help students that are coming out of high school that aren't as well prepared when we give them the special help.
Okay, good deal there. Innovate ABQ has been in the news a lot recently. Sure. You all, University of New Mexico, bought the old First Baptist Church downtown here. And within the last week, there's news that an older gentleman with a brain injury, his name is Sonny Hodge, he's lived there, he's looked over the place. Now it looks like this guy's going to be losing his home. Did you all know about this when you bought it?
No, we didn't recognize this at the time. It was a surprise to us. So we've STC, our scientific and the little corporation that's overseeing this part of UNM, put together a project to kind of crowdsource, raise money for him, and they've started off to a good start. They've raised $1,300. Mm-hmm. The idea would be is we want to buy him a trailer that he could live in, a camper, and it would be located at the new site where those folks are going to. And so this crowdsource is a site that people can go to. I think it's on your screen.
It is, yeah. There's a link at casa.com. Yeah. You talked about that. You're trying to raise $5,000. You have $1,300
exactly.
So far. How is it possible to buy it and not realize there was, a guy living there?
Well, you know, that's a very big organization that has been located at First Baptist. Mm. And there's a food bank there that's been operational and it's been very effective. And they're moving that whole food bank to another site. So we didn't know all the details of that food bank operation and know that Sonny was living there. And it was only after we got in and learned some of those things at the time of purchase that we found out about Sonny.
Would you be up for giving him a job with the new site and have him kind of do what he does, kind of a part-time security guard?
I think he'd be a lot better off going with the food bank down to the new site and being part of them because, you know, he's got a structured life that works very well with them. If he's down there, I think his life's going to be a lot better.
Okay, let's talk real quick about sports right now. If you didn't miss it last week, there was a lot happened in the NCAA world of sports. There was the NCAA losing a lawsuit against a guy named Ed O'Bannon, and there was also a big vote that you were involved in with the Mountain West. Bottom line, what all of this means, it's really confusing, is that universities could possibly be giving student athletes more.
Right. Our scholarships, the way we provide scholarships, is very rigid by the NCAA rules. Mm-hmm. The vote last week that the NCAA took said that five conferences that have what we call more resource conferences are the ones you see on TV the most, football
games. The SEC, the ACC.
Right, those guys. They got permission to put more resources to students. So they might fly their parents on the site visits, or they might be able to give more meal money to students. Now, the other conferences can follow along and do the same thing. So here in the Mountain
that
West,
Mountain West,
we could copy that. Now, so that's what that means, but we don't know yet how we're going to do that. They got permission. Nobody's figured it out yet. All those big conferences, some of them have a lot of money, like the big rich schools, Ohio State, Florida, the ones you see on TV the most often.
Sure.
In those conferences are schools like Indiana, Mississippi State. They don't have as much money. So even in the big schools, big differences in money. So nobody knows how it's going to play out yet. So we're all going to have to sort through it and see what the differences are and how all this is going to play out. Bottom line, huge changes in how college scholarships are working, what the rules of amateurism in college are going to be, and what it means for universities and the universities' relationships to their athletes. The O'Bannon rule, same difference about how we give share money that we get for athletes that are on TV games, video games.
Sure. Or so say you have an athlete, a college basketball player, basketball's big at UNM, whose jersey sells a lot.
Exactly.
How would you be compensating that player for that? I think that's what this lawsuit talks
about.
That's
what the O'Bannon lawsuit's about particularly.
Do you think eventually this is going to lead to college athletes, particularly basketball and football players in major schools, getting paid playing in college?
In some form, what it would probably mean is some sort of trust fund that gets created that the student would get upon graduation or leaving the school. I think that's the form it's moving to. But it's all
very... Do you think it's a good thing?
You know, it's a complicated thing. It has lots of ups and downs, and I think we have to think through it very carefully. You know, as a university president, my view is that these are student athletes. I want to see them be students first and get college degrees. I love college athletics. I was a college athlete. I went through on a scholarship, so I really support that part of it. But at the end of the day, I want them to be students first, and I think we have to preserve the student part of their experience.
Okay, real quick, UNM, your football team, Bob Davie, back on the field. Any guess on a record this year, how we're going to do? Are we going to be able to compete in the Mountain West?
We're going to compete in the Mountain West. We're going to have a very strong team. You know, what we want to do is, of course, get above 500. It's going to be a huge challenge, but Bob's got a great team, and he's a great coach, and we'll see how he performs.
I think we're very lucky to have him. Yeah. UNM President Bob Frank.
Thanks.
It's good to see you, Dr. Frank. Thanks for coming in.